went to one of the dinners, at that dinner at the Shoreham Hotel, and that led to this luncheon meeting I had in New York, at that time in my office, and one of the alumni staff, I forget his name now, bright young guy, he came up and he said to me, "How would you like to get involved with the alumni board?" And I said, "Gee, what a great idea, I'd love to."
We had a pretty solid leadership group there, small but solid. And it was a kind of a formal situation. Gail was very formal. She was a strategic planner, took that very seriously. So we did spend a lot of time doing 5-year strategic plans and having meetings about them. And
the New Directions Committee was really assigned with how can we make the Alumni Association a much more vital part of the university. And they were rethinking, what is the real purpose and mission of the Alumni Association? When I knew I was going to be president of the board, I was looking for my board. And one of the things I had always started to do when I took on volunteer leadership roles was, it used to be that people would just volunteer and you'd take whoever volunteered. And I realized in a prior role I'd had that you really needed to talk to the people and see what their level of commitment was and what were they really willing to do for the organization. And I don't even remember how the connection with Pam occurred. I had known of her. I don't know whether it was through the Alumni Association or something else, but I remember her and I sitting down for dinner and really talking about, you know, if she were to get involved, why was it important to her? And so she came on as my vice president.
We worked very hard at introducing ways that we could go about expanding the population that was involved in the selection of this Alumni Association board and engaging people in a lot of activities. It was at that point, really, the sort of late 80s through the 90s when I was so involved, that we revamped a lot of what was going on. One of the things that we did was come up with, you know, bylaws and sort of make the Alumni Association more of an entity that was not just a gathering of people, but that there were, you know, some agreed upon rules regarding how we would select officers, terms of office, participation.
I think the thing that I would say is none of what I was able to do when I was in the role as president of the Alumni Association would have happened without really great people. Great alumni that I was working with, you know, the people that were, you know, Brian, who was on as a media past president, Pam Deese, who was my vice president, Ed Verone, who was secretary, Sandra Walters, who was on my board. None of that would have happened without them.
We created a system where, you know, we actually have now elections for the alumni board, that in fact, it is a real prize. It's a real, it's an honor to be on the alumni board, and people vie for it, and they get nominated, and they really want to do it, and there are terms, and that, you know, is being on the alumni board is not in and of the end in and of itself. It's simply one way to serve AU and to be of value to AU, and then you can go and do something else.
The fact that the board has been not only ongoing, but that it's expanded in its reach, and there's a seems to me a substantial number of alums that participate in the board in all kinds of activities. The programming that has gone from, you know, I think we would have been happy with 10 events a year and an activity a month. I mean, now we're having hundreds of events touching thousands of alumni on an annual basis.
It's really great to know that there is a legacy that's been built on as a result of that foundation.
The ways in which that we connect to alums has changed dramatically. Students today, alums today, want information about their alma mater quickly. They want to know what's going on, and they need not just pick it up in the occasional mailer or campus magazine. They can see it on Twitter, they can see it on Facebook, they can see it on the evening news.
I've felt an obligation to the university for stepping up when I needed help as an 18, 19-year-old. To some alum who gave money to allow me to have a scholarship to come back that fall. And but for that, you know, and but for, there were a lot of but fors over the course of time, but it was always someone doing good that benefited me. And to the extent that, you know, we can do that, that we can leave a mark and a legacy.
It's very true, actually, that I do feel an obligation to AU. That in fact, when I came to AU, at the end of my sophomore year, my financial aid had been cut off, and it was significant. It was kind of dramatic. And in fact, we were told, I got home for summer vacation, and it was, oh, you know, my mother was distressed. She's like, you can't go back. We don't have money to send you back. And there was a guy at the AU financial aid office, and he fixed it. And he basically said, don't worry, Mrs. Keene, we're going to take care of this. Tell your son, Brian, to come to my office, and we'll make sure he's all set. And they did. And they actually reinstated everything for junior and senior year and made sure it was all right. And I knew that when I first came to AU, that it was that attention to the person that actually mattered. In that way, I do think, well, yeah, I should give back. You know, AU gave me so much, I should give back.
If you're an alum out there, no matter where you are across the country, you know, reach out to the Alumni Association. There's ways that you can get involved, you know, to support the university and not just writing them a check every year. Like I talked, there are more ways now probably than when we thought them up.
You know, I think I've always at some level had this feeling that as we have great opportunities, we have an obligation to give back. You know, it's just part of what we do. And, you know, American University was really instrumental in setting me on the path that I ended up on professionally.
When you look at the factors that brought us all together, the decision to go to school in Washington, D.C., selecting American, and then the internship and job experiences that we all had in some way together, it makes sense that when you get a bunch of alumni in the room, even if they're 10 or 20 years apart in age, they all had a very similar experience from that perspective. The other element that really unites us is a commitment to volunteerism and service and giving back.
From the professors that taught me, to the clubs and activities that I participated in, to the guest lecturers and speakers that came to campus, AU blessed me with an education that I am still benefiting from and hope to benefit from for the remainder of my days. And I want to make sure that the next generation of AU students have the same opportunity that I had.
I'm fortunate to have made some great personal and professional friendships during my time on the alumni board, and I continue to stay in touch with many of the folks that I have had the opportunity to serve with. We get together for drinks and dinner, but some of us also continue to have professional relationships where we have opportunities to work together in our various career paths, and both are very rewarding.
Because the gift what AU gives people is not just an education, it is a lifelong connection to humanity. And what it does is re-inspires me every day to make sure everything that I'm doing is recognizing what AU's mission is, to put ideas into action and action into service.
It really starts from the top, and then it goes really through the administration and then to the faculty and staff. That every person, every individual is an individual, and they are family, and actually you really take care of your own.
Some of my biggest and most impactful connections at AU were my colleagues and my fellow students. I grew and developed lifelong friendships with people at AU.
It's not just an institution, it is a community, it is a family, it is my family. It's been an integral part of my life from when I stepped foot here as a freshman in 1976 to today. So much of what I know, who I've become, friendships, role models, how I spend my time, the impact on my children, my family, it has all centered here.
These are profiles of volunteers that not only give their dollars, but their time and their heart to AU. And on behalf of the current board and all of our 125,000 global alumni, I just want to say thank you.